discuss present tense of the industrial structures, construction of present tense in construction, and what I face, mostly the failures of industrial structures during the, because of the defects in design and construction, particularly fabrication and erection. So what I personally, I wanted to bring it to your notice, all the things. Failures and collapse of buildings are mainly caused due to the following man-made deficiencies, disastrous effect of natural forces such as cyclone, wind load, seismic load, explosive loads or fire loads. 50% of the total structures are due to defective designs, predominantly by ignoring essential requisites including overall stability in plane and lateral stability, in plane, out of plane. When you erect a structure, you must see that the structure is erected on that, is it in plane stable or out of plane is stable. By connecting the bottom members, top, whether it is goes out of the, is, whether it is false or stable. This is the main criteria to check the, despite being the defects in lateral stability, we have to see whether the structure is stable in plane and out of plane. For example, structure here. This is here. 15 years back, it is a 30-meter span of the truss. In this, bottom cord is designed with the two channels here, top two channels side by side with internal members of 30-meter span. They started erecting one truss by one truss like that, and they have made purlins, bottom ties, and later and at the end to the gable columns. Unfortunately, by that time, gable columns are not lifted, not raised. So what he has done is, he has lifted that. Erection is with the cranes, derricks, whatever may be. Then he has erected the structure and go on connecting to the top purlins and bottom cords. And at the end, he has forgotten to tie the entire structure, longitudinal ties, whatever may be, to the gable columns. Then what happened, after removing, after taking out the cranes, the structure has collapsed. By the connecting the bottom cord, bottom cord member purlins, or the bottom cord members to the gable columns. To the gable columns. Gable columns are not raised. So what my submission to you is, we have to see whether the structure is designed for loads, whether the structure is stable during operation, during erection, and after thereafter. So in this, presently designers are accustomed for the model analysis. They are not following 3D models. They are doing planar models. Even PEV softwares also, when you ask 3D models, they are not inclined to give it. They are giving only plane frame. Plane frame cannot give you whether structure is stable in plane and out of plane. So the structure has collapsed. What I did is, the bottom cord, when I came to erection is there, when I taken it here, two channels are side by side, but not angles, channels. What I did is, I have taken two channels apart by 150 mm. And all the diagonal members, the vertical members of, I have put it inside and welded it. And seen that the structure is stable. And I see the first, the erector has, 10 people of his people are dead. It has not come forward. Then I asked, I fabricated. I got it fabricated. And seen that truss of 30 meters standing on the legs of the column legs. And see that the structure is stable. He's standing on his legs is vertically without lateral deflection, lateral sway. So then with lateral sway, is not yet done, the structure is erected, is okay. That my submission to the, my point is here, the structure which I designed by putting the sections here, the sections I put it side by side, I put it only at a gap of 150 mm. So what I did is, by putting a gap of 150 mm, 200 mm, then I have ensured the lateral stability of the structure. So while designing the structures must be seen, vertical stability, in-plane stability, out-of-plane stability. That is most important test. In the design of the structure also, here most of the people have to see, the designers are failing to see the connections in at all the members must meet at one point. Otherwise, eccentricity develops. These are issues which you have to see this one next. And taking the loads, now, main problem is missing of periodic site strict supervision during fabrication and vital requirement of 100% visual inspection of wells along with the radiograph testing and appropriate quality checking. And my request to all if the design engineers, he has to visit the site during fabrication or during erection, and before erection also, he has to inspect the structure and see that whether the design is done, is reproduced there, reflected, his design is reflected there in the fabrication. So what is happening is, the structure earlier I have shown, it is failed because the design engineer has not seen the site because he was paid, this happened 15 years back. It is because he is paid only 5,000 rupees. So he says, I have designed the structure. I don't have time or you have not paid me money to inspect. If he had inspected the site before erection, you would have seen that the structure was not stable. So the question is, my request to all the people who are even designers, the first designers must see the structures, what all he is designing, and he has to see the design and see that whether there are missings are there in that. Whether the design he has some, because of during he might miss the some connection details or something like that, or his draftsman might have missed this. At least he will see that structure and that structure is certain. That's why my request to all of the designers or builders or owners, they must ensure that the designer of the structure must come to site and check the designs. That is the most important of that. Then another thing is, there are three elements is there. One is design, the detailing. Nowadays detailing is, design of steel structure is very easy, but not detailing. Detailing is very important in the steel construction. The detailing, you must see that it must be economical, optimum way, and the gusset plate thicknesses and the welding must be designed as per the loads that is coming. That is more important because most of the top end, the consultants, they say they give the design drawing, they give it to a fabricator. Fabricator will design the detailing. And that gentleman, the fabricator, he doesn't have a good qualified engineers. He puts the designs, detailing is not perfectly done. So designer must, whoever designs the building, he must get it done with his assistants, or he must check the detailing done by the fabricator. Then only he will ensure not only safety or another thing is economy, entire this one. That is important. That's why lack of coordination of all activities, the construction among all the connected agencies to ensure quality production, quality construction has been the most important phase of structure failure. Mostly this has happened. Another thing, inappropriate needed maintenance of erection to reduce environmental extreme weather conditions, site including maintenance aspect of structure exposed to corrosion and chemical attacks. In structures in chemical plants, which I have faced here, in particularly on paper board, Gajrachan paper boards, what happened is the chlorine dioxide will come out. In chlorine dioxide, what comes out, no, the structure of the supporting, sheet supporting structures and the trusses get corroded in no time. In which case, you should not insist upon steel construction. You must do it with a precast pavements, precast trusses, and our composite constructions of columns also must be composite constructions with the steel columns and case with concrete. So that chemical attack is very important for this, to safeguard the structure. You have to ensure that your structure must resist the chemical attack. That is the point. Then I want to discuss one more thing. Particularly the PEB suppliers, they are not seeing nowadays, the PEB suppliers, what they are quoting, nowadays most of the suppliers are quoting as per the rate rate per square foot. One of them rents in the other day, last year in the one seminar, whatever 2005 they are quoting the rates, 2018 also they are quoting the same rates. So you see whether the technology is improved or they are making patra. So that's what I say is, particularly what I request is any PEB suppliers, they must quote as per the not square foot basis, only on ton basis. If they do ton basis, what they do is, then the cost of the construction that the owner will be knowing how much tons will be involved, what is the rate per ton. That is the you will see. Otherwise, what is happening is, see, they are not looking after quarter provisions. They are not supplying the 3D model. They are supplying nowadays, some of the, not all, some of the PEB suppliers are not giving the 3D model. They are giving only plain frame model. The other conditions, they are not bar corrosion, they are not bothered. See, for example, they are putting the main columns of plates 4 mm. That is 4 mm, web thicknesses are 4 mm. 4 mm only. And main gutters are also only 4 mm to 6 mm. For structures in seashore structures also, in a core storage plants, let us say core storage plant, there the weather conditions are, particularly corrosion aspect is more, corrosion effect is more, and a structure which I have come across, I will tell you. See, the structure is 60 by 60 meters is my personal experience. 60 by 60 meters they have, I've designed a conventional type of structures. And for a cost of around 1.6 crores, 1.6 crores, conventional structure. Then one gentleman of PEB supplier came and put it as reduced 40 lakhs. Though I have designed this, for him, I'm a big Bada plant, Abhijit Ferro Alliance. I designed a lot of structures for them, Ferroalloys plant, Bada plants. I told them the structure is absolutely, is situated in seashore, 4 kilometers from the sea, one. It is a cold storage shed, two. Third is cyclonic weather and windowed. They have designed such a way that their structure is 40 lakhs reduced. And the owner is preferred, is not the fault of only PEB supplier. Owner wanted only the safety of the owner wanted the reduction of cost, despite being the fact that this is, see, the main gutter is a 4 mm thickness. They provide 4 mm thickness for 4 mm thickness. D by T ratios and the slenderness ratios is exceeding 85. There are no stiffness are provided. One. Buckling is not at all, lateral buckling is not at all bothered about it. And in that way, they reduced 30 lakhs, 30 to 40 lakhs. They preferred that structure compared to my structure. I'm not saying PEB construction or construction is a good quality construction, but they are taking like this. In that one, few examples I will tell you. Here, the sag rods are provided connecting the pulleys. The sag rod, when you are providing connecting all rods here, this should be connected at the end by trusses. That is not done. That is called sag rod bracing at the ridge. It is not done. Then there are no longitudinal, internal columns are there. There are no tie beams. Internal tie beams, there are no tie beams at all for the internal columns. And the particularly main gutters are also 4 mm thick to 4 to 6 or 5 mm thick only. Then next is, but just next word. Right. See, and we asked him to supply 3D model. He has not supplied. He doesn't want to supply at all. So, see, the main point is the pitiable case is some owners are choosing suppliers the base of lowest bidder. It is not a fault of PEB supplier at all. It is a rat racing. It is suppliers are based on the lowest price. Whoever gives less price, whether the structure is stable. That's why most of the PEB suppliers are only giving the only stability certificate for only 15 years or 10 to 15 years. That also you insist upon. Though safety of the structure, though life of the structure is required 70 years, or 50 to 70 years. But they are on 50 years. In spite of that, the people are not insisting upon to give the structures to ensure the quality, strength and safety and all this, they are not bothered about. See, both builders are referring to disastrous, catastrophic failure of the buildings, but not trying to correct themselves. There is immense task of use, finance and human loss. The structures are designed, they are not bothered. For example, this I designed the same structure for wind speed of 50, closely estimated to the cold storage, site is situated approximately 4 kilometers, shed size is 60 meters, estimated price is, without foundation is 1.66 crores according to me, for whereas PEB supplies 1.24. So because the cost is less, and the, funnily, see, there are no longitudinal beams provided between column to column. There are no sag rod bracing. Thickness above the main column and portal beam is only 4 mm, which is not sufficient for corrosion point of view. Web stiffness to arrest local beckoning gutters are not provided, even though D by T ratio is more than 85. Roofs, then another point is, for a structures of industrial structures, the slope of the, particular slope of the roof must be little more than 10 degrees or more than, not 5 degrees, because there is a possibility of dust getting, say, accumulated on the structure. Because of coal, dust getting accumulated. So dust to wash, the, normally all the structures which are subjected to dust accumulation, as per code, you have to provide the, you have to take the weight of the load, of dust load. That is may vary. For a cement plant, maybe 100 kg per meter square. For a cold storage plant, 50 kg per meter square. That there, nobody is bothered to take that. So, then, so I tell you, my experience is, for structures, there is a clinker tank, is there. Example, I will tell you. What I come across, structure, clinker tank. Roof. See, there is a clinker storage silo. On that, there is a roof. There is a roof here. The roof is having a slope of 30 degrees. Despite being 30 degrees, not 5 degrees, 30 degrees, because of the cement dust getting settled. Because morning, let us say, dust getting settled on the roof. Evening there is a drizzle, a rain, light rain. So the cement dust gets settled. Cement dust gets settled there on the roof. Then what happens? Then there is a periodic supervision will not be 3 months or 4 months if you do it also. This dust, there, so many structures are getting collapsed. See, we are strengthening, but this maintenance is not there. Now what is happening is, this dust getting settled now, despite being the fact also, the structures are not designed for a dust load of 100 kg per meter square. So where the loads are to be taken, as per a codal provision, that has not been done. The only thing is, important is finance. So how much, cost implication, the cost implication is there, I agree. But these are the type of structures which are, I show you, in particularly in cement plants, in my life, I have strengthened this existing structures with increasing the load of 100 kg per meter square after seeing the failures of the structures. So what I say is, dust loads, and what I come to this one, first the question of taking loads as per codes. So whether dead load or live load, or in this case in North India snow load, and whatever in particular industrial structures dead load, it has to be taken appropriately in the, for the long duration of the life. Particularly in this case, right? This structure, Now then the another thing is this dust load. Then it comes to wind load. If I talk about less about wind load, is better. Because when any structure collapses in, say, in 1977, all our seashore structures are getting collapsed, and you say, engineers are going, no, structure is collapsed because of cyclone has come, what can I do? In airport, Vizag airport, last cyclone, the entire roof is got damaged. But people are getting accustomed, but now they are not designing for the wind load as per the 50, cyclonic wind load as 50 meters per second. So what I personally feel is, the engineers, structural engineers or builders, one as whoever may be, must take the actual wind loads coming on that. For example, suppose if you design a truss, the bottom cord is subjected to compression. For a dead end load, is a tension, but bottom cord compression. Compression must be there, must be tie beams, longitudinal ties, which is nobody is bothered about longitudinal ties. See, question is, what I personally feel is, the uplift conditions on the structures must be taken care of by taking appropriately about, because alternate tension or compression. This is not done in the wind load. The structures are getting collapsed. For Vijayanagaram, I have designed their plant, ferroalloy plant, and a structure, I've seen the structure done, given by China. That is, nowadays every product is coming from China. So because they give less rate, that is the only problem. Then they're China, then I saw the structure and told, the structure will collapse for a wind of 40 meters per second. Then they laughed at me. Then after the structure, one cyclone, 2014 or 15 cyclone, what happened? The water telephoned to me. Then I said, I thought this fellow is telephoning to me, said that my structure is safe. Because yesterday there was a cyclone, my structure is safe. Rao Saab, the structure is collapsed in toto. That I show you that structure. Structure is collapsed in toto. Then I told him, sir, I will design with the same cost, proper design. But the gentleman has preferred to go to again China and brought the coal storage building. So what I personally feel is, the owner is not at all bothered about the human loss, about financial loss. Financial loss, I think they're not bothered because insurance parties are, they give. But what about the financial loss? They're not bothered about. The idea behind is, structures of India, particularly coastal areas, even base plate of column is designed for compression. When it comes to the uplift due to column, it is only base plate is taken by 4 or 6 boards. That boards, we have to design a condition where the uplift condition you have to design, which normally we don't take it. For all the things in a wind load, cyclonic wind load, the members are becoming compression members. Compression members, the buckling has to be taken care of. The wind load has to be seen. Or side cladding members or roof members. So what they say is, some people will argue, sir, due to cyclone, the J-bolt of Kulin is now getting weakened. Its sheet gets blown off. My structure is safe. So, but I'm not designed for the structure. And particularly the PEB suppliers also, what I request the PEB suppliers, if anybody, must take care of this wind load aspects of, particularly the boards, foundation boards, also the uplift load. That is, these foundation boards, in the case of compression, these are boards will take. When it comes to uplift of the column, this line of boards are there. This will act as a bending member. That has to be checked. Rather, that is a worst scenario in checking of the base plate. And the columns also must see whether the column of tension is capable of taking or not. This is to be done. Next is the aspect is corrosion. The corrosion aspect of this one, particularly structures. Nowadays, all the designers, builders, contractors, or everybody forgot that corrosion is not required, durability is not there. As long as we live, the structure, if it's safe, is okay. That is the concept of this one. So the corrosion, even 6 mm plate in a corrosive atmosphere, in chemical cold storage sheds or chemical atmosphere, in bulk drug plants and paper plants, this 6 mm thickness of the plates, main sections are not sufficient. Even if you try before the owner or contractor, they are not bothered about it. My agony is there. Nowadays, the life of the people are taken easy. Let it go. We'll give 30 lakhs for them, that is okay, but we don't correct ourselves. So the question is, because of corrosion, in another very important aspect of which I have observed in my life, we are thinking corrosion in seashore structures. But I designed a cement plant at northeast Meghalaya, I designed it 3 years back. I went now, suppose after 3 years I've seen, the most of the structures are got damaged because of corrosion. There's no sea. Then what is the reason is, because alternate wetting and drying, in particularly Meghalaya side, morning there's hot sun, evening there's a big shower. So due to the hot conditions, the variation of the temperature variation, cold, the material is getting corroded. This is a very, very important phenomenon which I observed, which I did not see any textbooks and all, any authors, they have not written. And structures are getting damaged, sea structures, particularly conveyors of the cement plants, of cement plants, getting damaged.